welcome to my channel. So I'm just about to show you how to do these victory rolls in your hair. If you're interested in seeing how I did it, stay right there and watch to the end. Right, so let's get this started then, shall we? So for this, I'm going to need to take a teasing brush. Mine's just a little brush like this. It's got my hair in it. And it's got the, what do you call it, the sectioning bit at the end. You will need some hairspray and you will need your bobby pins. Okay, so I would normally do this on my hair once I've actually put my heated rollers in it, or I've pin curled it or something. If you've got a wave in your hair, it's a bit, little bit easier, so it's up to you whether you want to or not, but today I'm not going to. I'm just going to do it on straight hair. Okay, so what I do is I want to do my section. I'm going to go, rather than go just there like my pattern is, which gives you a thinner bit of hair here, I'm actually going to go more diagonal that way. Okay, so okay, so my parting is more like that, and then as you can see, you then have a bit more hair this side to play with. And then what I do is I then say this side here, I will section it right the way down to just about there on the ear, about there. Okay, and then this will become my first part. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to take some little sectioning clips, and I'm just going to try and get this bit here just out of the way a little bit. So I'll just section that off out of the way. There we go, hold that out of the way. Okay, so next bit. So what you need to do, or what I like to do, I mean, we're all different. I'm not trained hairdresser or anything like that. This is just how I like to do mine victory rolls. So I bring the hair up like this. I don't bring it up like that. I bring it sort of like this to an angle. Okay. And then what I do is tease it, give it lots of teasing. Tease it at the back, tease it at the front, just loads of teasing. So that's going to really help you roll. And then what I do is give it a little bit of a blitz of spray. Like that. Just letting that dry off a little bit. So I'm going to get a couple of pins ready. Okay. And let me see if I can start to make my roll. Okay, so take the end and you can just like wrap that around your finger a little bit, and then I just like to walk it down like this until you decide where you want your roll to be. Okay, so that's like my first bit in, and then
Boogie, boogie, bugle, bugle, company. when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B.
Now, there are all different types of victory rolls that you can do. You can have some that are like just like a roll like mine, more or less, or you can actually move this so that that bit there becomes a little bit flatter and you can actually see inside of the roll. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to give this a little bit of a spray and all these like little loose bits are just smooth them down. So it sometimes is a little bit easier if you're doing it on your hair that's been curled, because you've got like that little bit of a natural bend in your hair. So now I'm going to do the same on the other side. So I'll do that. Right, so I've sectioned my hair off in exactly the same way, okay, and now I'm just going to give it a good old tease. This isn't something, because I've got quite fine hair, and this isn't something that I do to my hair every day, purely because of all the teasing. So, yeah, but I do like to do it occasionally. And then just give it a jolly good conditioner, like a conditioner mask or something afterwards. Okay, so I'm just going to do my roll. Sometimes people do it by, you can just walk the curl down by holding it like that, and you can walk it down. Depending on where you want your victory curl to be, you can sort of stop when you think you've achieved where you want it. Some people like it to be brought down further onto their face. I don't really, I prefer it to be off my face a little bit. Just put my first pin in. That's the first one in. Those little bits in. As I say, there are so many different types that you can do. You can have them so that the curls, like the rolls, are coming this way, all sorts of things. And then it's up to you what you do with the back. I mean, if my hair had been curled, as I said, or if I'd pin curled it or used heated rollers on it, this bit at the back here would have been all nice and sort of weight. I could have done some 1940s waves. I could have like brushed them out to get the waves. But I'm thinking what I might do is, I'm going to do an upward roll from the back. So it's the same sort of principle. So you just grab your hair exactly the same way as the victory roll, same principle, and then you just roll with your fingers like that. So use my bobby pin, smooth all the bits out in a minute, just sort of get it into place first. So just get this into place. Especially on days like today, I mean, here in the UK it is so blooming hot, it's like come out of nowhere. So if you've got your hair up, where I like to wear my hair up a lot of the time anyway, so not perfect today, but then I'm not really spending a lot of time on it, am I? I'm just sort of doing it to show you how I do my victory rolls with this particular style anyway. Just need that bit in there a bit more. There we go. Open that out a little bit. Okay, so there we are. That is the actual victory rolls done. Say so sometimes I do them. Can you see this one? It's got more of a little swirl there. This one actually, well, it has, but you have to look in there. But you can do the victory rolls where you bring them up closer together and then you have the curl here, the little swirl, and it stands up a little bit more and it gives you more of like a heart shape on the top of your head. But I'll come back when I've just finished the look a little bit. So there we are, that's my, listen, everyday look of the victory rolls. So I've got my victory roll here. It depends what you want to put on the top of your head. I've just put a scarf on, just rolled it up and then tied it in a knot on the top and just tucked it under. I'm just going to put some earrings in that will complement the look. There you go. If you're going for an evening look, well, if it was me personally, if I was going for an evening look, I wouldn't put the scarf on the top. I'd have my hair probably curly at the back or sleek at the back, sort of turning under, and bigger victory rolls that maybe came up a little bit higher. But I think for the daytime, this is actually quite a nice little look. I have also done it before where I've taken the scarf from under here and tied it up on the top. A bit like you may remember your grandma doing that sort of thing. I can remember my nan doing that anyway. So yeah, I thought I'd just share this with you. So this is my quick and easy on straight hair victory roll look. And I will take a photograph of the back for you and I'll insert it in the video. So I hope you've enjoyed it. If you'd like to see any more vintage hairstyles, just let me know. Comment down below in the little box below. Subscribe to my channel and press that notification bell and then you'll know when I do my next uploads. But until then, can't wait to see you in the next video. Stay safe and stay fabulous. Bye. Bye-bye.
And the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's a boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B.